Matt, what are you doing, crafts?
No, I'm actually working on a demonstration for random selection. I have selected some beads to represent people, and I have three different colors, red, white, and blue, representing a single trait, but I have three different versions, the red, white, and blue versions.
Okay, but why did you put them in the bottle?
Well, the bottle is representative of the whole population of people living in a region, for example. We have roughly equal frequencies of all the colors in our population, though there's a slight increase in the number of red individuals living at the sort of top of the bottle. Okay. Now, for this to be representative of random selection, we need an event to happen that's completely random.
How about a meteor?
A meteor, that sounds great. So a meteor strike is coming to Earth, and it comes to this region and... Now notice what happened is all these people, a couple still trying to survive there, everybody that survived ran away and got away from the meteor, and those that weren't able to run fast enough stayed in the bottle, and unfortunately they didn't survive. And so the people who survived were able to run away here into the glass dish, and those that couldn't are still here in the bottle. Unfortunately, these didn't survive. And what I want you to notice, if we see here, is that tell me the frequency difference between the individuals in the bottle and those in the glass dish.
Well, it looks like most of the red survived, but not as many blue and white beads did.
Exactly, and that's because there was a change in the allelic frequency due to a random selection event.
Oh, the bottleneck effect.
Exactly. You can see here we've represented that quite literally. And so those in the bottle didn't survive. We changed the allelic frequency, more red in the dish, those that survived. And now we have a change that resulted from a completely random event.